Hi there, need to learn how to insert multiple rows into Excel? Let me help. Hey, I'm Sharyn from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you save time, work smarter, and improve your Microsoft Office skills. So, let's look at how you can quickly insert multiple rows into Excel. I'm going to cover some really quick and easy ways, including some fantastic shortcuts. If you're using my 100 plus steps to Proficient workbook to improve your Excel skills, I've also popped the topic number this video relates to in the description box below. Now, if you haven't yet claimed a copy of this workbook, I'll explain where you can grab your copy at the end of this video. Right, let's get you inserting multiple rows. Right, let's look at how you can quickly insert multiple rows into Excel. Now, you may be familiar already with how you can insert a single row simply by going over the row number, getting your little black arrow, doing a right click and insert. And of course, you can easily just insert that into your worksheet. Now, you may not know this, but you've got your F4 key. So function key 4 is a repeat key. And if you press that now, you will actually have the opportunity to repeat the last thing you did, which was insert a row. And of course, that F4 has now allowed you to put multiple rows into your worksheet. So I'm just going to undo that and I'll show you another option. So let's say I wanted a new row 4, a new row 5, and a new row 6. Now I've just selected over each one of those rows. Now when I do a right click and an insert, you're going to see that's exactly what's happened. So you can select over the number of rows that you want and then do your insert and it'll put into your worksheet the number of rows required. Okay, I'll just undo this one. Now that's great when the rows are adjacent, but what if they're not adjacent? So let's say I needed a new row underneath Dalton's here, so I'll just select there, and I needed a new row under Stevens. Now you can hold down your control key, so I've just done a normal select, just clicking onto number 5 there to select the entire row. I'm coming down underneath Stevens here, and I'm holding down my control key on the keyboard and I'm clicking. And we'll do one more, maybe under Sally down here. And so what I've done is I've actually selected the areas where the rows need to be inserted. Same deal, you just do a right click, insert, and you'll see now one under Sally, one under Stevens, and one under Dalton's. So that's another way that you can do it. So that's really good for non-adjacent rows. Right, let's undo that. And I'll just show you a really, really cool shortcut. So if you are in your data and you want to really quickly insert a row into your data, Alt-I-R, easy. Just like that, and it'll insert it in. And of course, at this point, you can use your F4 key. So repeat the last thing you did, F4, F4, F4. And of course, you can easily put multiple rows in if you want to. Same thing, I'll just come back up here and undo that. And if I highlight it over here, Alt-I-R, it'll do the same thing. It'll insert the number of rows that you need. I'll just undo that. And if you're wondering if Alt-I and the R stands for row, it's exactly what it is. Alt-I, insert R, row. So if I did Alt-I, C, it does it for a column as well. So that's just a little extra hint or tip. And of course, if I needed to, I could easily do my Control-Z to take it out, or I could do my Alt-I, C, and I could do my F4 key to repeat it. I hope that's been helpful. So I really hope this instruction has been helpful and you are now able to quickly insert multiple rows into your worksheet. Now, if you're really serious about improving your Excel skills and you'd love an idea of just what you need to know to become a more than proficient user of Excel, click the link in the description box below to grab your copy of our Steps to Becoming Proficient in Excel guide. A brilliant tool to use to assess your current skill level, identify gaps in your knowledge, and learn where to find the information you'll need to fill any gaps you've identified. Now, if this video has been helpful, please hit the like button and please let me know in the comments below. And if you use Excel and want to stay connected, please consider following, subscribing, because I'm sharing new videos regularly. And if you know anyone who would benefit from this help, please be sure to share this video with them. Hey, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.